most expensive home on the planet. In the inner city of Mumbai, India, not far from the poverty-stricken slums, on the renowned Altamont Road, stands Antilia, the most expensive home ever created. This home ascends 27 stories, stretching 568 feet high, granting the massive structure with prime views of the Arabian Sea. In technical terms, the home is the second most expensive residential property in the world, considering Buckingham Palace is worth around $5 billion. However, Buckingham Palace is considered a crown property, whereas Antilia is a private residence. And the most expensive private residential property at that, with some pricing estimates as high as $2 billion. Even still, any list in which a residence is preceded by Buckingham Palace pretty much guarantees that place is going to be over the top luxurious and is likely a house I'd love to move into. In this video, I'll take you on a virtual, informative tour of this ostentatious estate while engaging all of two of your senses. In this massive home, there are several ceilings that are double or triple heighted, so the 27-floored skyscraper looks more like a 50 or 60-floored building. Of the lower floors, there is a multi-level car lot that can hold 168 vehicles, including Mukesh's precious RS5 Craw Maybach, a car for very important people. Somewhere in that car lot is also a car service station. The home also has three helipads placed on the roof. Few things say billionaire like more than one helipad on the roof. Both the private car lot and helipads are violations of residential bylaws in Mumbai, but from what we can tell, no one has forced the billionaire's hand to make any changes. Above the car lot, you'll find an extravagant lobby composed of 9 elevators. Further up is a 2-story recreation center with a lap pool, a gym, a juice bar, a dance studio, and a yoga studio. As you continue to ascend, you will eventually run into a spa and a ballroom. The ballroom is adorned with multiple crystal chandeliers that cover 80% of the ceiling. To capitalize on the entertainment focus areas of the home, there's a movie theater that sits 50 viewers. There are multiple balconies and terraces with luscious gardens hanging over the sleek facade along the home. The vegetation attached to the sides of the building are meant to absorb sunlight in order to keep the interior as cool as possible. The home comes fitted with an ice room equipped with a snow generator, meant to mimic a winter wonderland. The immaculate structure was designed by architects Perkins and Will out of Chicago, and the interior design was overseen by an Australian company called Lytton Holdings. While the 400,000 square foot building is home to just 6, it's also meant to make room for a staff of 600 cooks, cleaners, and security personnel. The building is named after a legendary island, also called the Isle of the Seven Cities. The tale of this island originates from an old Liberian legend in which bishops fleeing from the Muslim conquest of Hispania escaped to an island and created 7 settlements there. Considering the unique shape of the skyscraper and the fact that its construction cost not 6, not 7, not 8, but 10 figures, it'd be a fair assumption to presume the design of the home is symbolic, or at least, you know, on purpose. And that assumption would be correct. This incredible structure was meticulously crafted with Hindi influence and generously laced with religious symbolism. Within the 27 stories, there are 6 sections of the home that are meant to reflect earth, water, fire, air, sound, and light. These elements were placed from bottom to top as to mimic the ascension to enlightenment. Throughout the mansion, there are 2 reoccurring motifs, the sun and the lotus. These symbols are meant to represent rebirth. The materials used to stand for these themes include marble, crystal, and none other than Mother of Pearl. There is a temple in the home in which the family of 6 goes to pray regularly. There are many statues of Hindu deities throughout the home, including the Hindu god Ganesh, revered as the remover of obstacles, and Shiva, the Hindu deity who destroys to make way for new creation. Along with religious themes and the motifs of lotus and sun, the house is said to have been inspired by the Atlantic Ocean. The owner of the $2 billion home is Mukesh Ambani, a petroleum titan, chairman of Reliance Industries and, surprise, surprise, the richest man in India. Mukesh is responsible for a fifth of India's exports, which is absolutely outrageous considering India makes up for a third of the Earth's population. Mukesh's father created a business that turned into the world's biggest producer of polyester fibers and yarns. Mukesh multiplied his inheritance many times over to become one of the richest men in all of Asia. For years, Mukesh was a member of the top 10 richest people in the world. And during one surge in India's stock market in 2007, he was believed to be the richest man on the planet. But as of recently, he sits comfortably at the 20th spot. Mukesh is worth $40.1 billion and is 61 years old. Mumbai is the commercial capital of India and is also called the city that never sleeps. This city is also home to the entertainment industry in India, so it's commonly known as Bollywood. While the city is home to the world's most expensive house, it's unfortunately also home to the world's largest slum. While the house was built on the richest stripe of land in the city, it's hard to not notice the contrast in a city like Mumbai, with such depths of poverty just blocks away. Years before the creation of Antilia, Mukesh bought his wife an Airbus for her birthday for $60 million. He had the passenger jumbo jet refitted with a living room, a bedroom, satellite TV, a sky bar, and a spa. Unlike most families worth billions, the Ambani family owns just the one home as opposed to the expected several around the globe. The children of Mukesh and Nita all studied at universities in the States. That's pretty much all I've got on Antilia and the Ambani family. If you enjoyed the video, make sure to leave a like and subscribe.